Underdog, he rock. Come on the track like, ha, people. Watch you get mangled. Shine like a star. My nickname is Spangle. Keep your guard up. I'm coming from all...
If it wasn't for music, man, I don't know exactly where I'd be right now. You know, it's the one thing I truly, truly give a damn about, aside from family. It was my escape from my terrible reality at the time. I'm Alfred Banks. I'm a 25-year-old rapper from here in New Orleans, Louisiana, and my parents got evicted. I was homeless. I know my pops had a history of doing some illegal activity. You know, my brothers dabbled here and there into some things, and I just had a cousin earlier this year, Day-Day. He got murdered. Even though my family may have done it, a couple people, they always shielded me from it. They always made sure I never had to do that type of thing. So seeing that type of stuff, yeah, I could have jumped into it. I could have made a call and be like, yo, put me in the game. But I wasn't built like that. I wasn't, you know, I was the music kid. I was the kid that was academically gifted. I started rapping like my oldest brother, Alandis Banks. My oldest brother was really good with the written rhymes. My middle brother, James, was really good with freestyling. And so I kind of wanted to impress those guys. So I started rhyming at like 6 years old. I was still their raps. Kind of mix them together and try to rap it back to them as if they didn't know it was their music. You know, dealing with my brother's death, March 20th, 2014, he suffered from schizophrenia and he committed suicide. And my oldest brother was my support system. When I was a kid going through middle school, getting picked on every day, I would call him to get inspiration to want to live the next day. He just disappeared for 10 years and we didn't know why. And when he came back, we realized that he was going through mental illness issues and he didn't know how to tell us. And then 6-7 months later, after him coming back in my life, he was gone for good. And it really took a toll on me. So my latest project I did, called A Beautiful Prelude, pretty much it's a 3-track EP, and it recreates the day I found out he passed away. Cause here in New Orleans, like, the mental illness thing is pretty bad. Like, if you walk down Canal Street, man, you just see it. Like, there's 25 people homeless just back to back and they all talking to themselves, you know? And nobody does anything about it. And I want to make it cool to rap about it, to bring that topic up, you know? And being a black person that's talking about that type of thing is even crazier, because the history of black people, like, we were slaves. So even in positions where we had no control, we were always expected to just be bigger than life. You gotta be strong, you gotta be hard as hell, you gotta be tough as nails, you gotta be thick skinned. We had no time to sit and lick our wounds. Even not being as informed on politics that I am, I know they both suck. But if anybody, I guess Hillary has more of an opportunity than Trump, because he's not even a real presidential candidate. So I guess I'll go with Hillary by default, you know? If anybody has the chance to change this racial issue, would be her, given her husband was so popular with black people. The only problem is they know that they're popular with black people, so they exploit us. I am reminded a lot that I'm a black kid in New Orleans, you know? I've been called nigger. The moment I open my mouth, people, oh, he speaks so well. It's like, the fuck, am I six? Like, what am I, a dog? It's upsetting, you know what I mean? And even halfway across the world, I'm still black. But, you know, we persevere.
When my brother died, I got his collection of fitted cats. But real talk, I wish he was alive so I could give him back. Cause man, it hurts, the only way he's alive is in my raps. But since my lyrics are his heartbeat, I'm killing every track.